good evening and welcome to Scott Valley Hairdressing. This is where it's all happening here tonight. Thank you so much for all of you that join us on these special presentations. Every one of these presentations is special. Do you know why? Because we get to create something magic as hairdressers. We get to create something special, something magical. I always say that these presentations are amazing because one of the things is you've got the amazing part is using amazing products, which tonight we're working with Mutt products, which we're good evening to everybody in Australia. If you're watching tonight, Luke, Scott, Clive, Mark, Paula, Leah, you're all there tonight. Good evening. G'day. Also, be good evening to everybody in the United Kingdom at Mook as well. Alan, Lawrence, everybody at Mook Central, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to do this. And again, for being your UK Artistic Director, thank you very much. And again, you get to see how the products work tonight in harmony with the haircut, how the system works that we cut with. And those of you also, one of the reasons I always say it's amazing because hairdressers are amazing. What I say they're amazing, they cope with a lot of problems. People bring problems to them every day, problems with hair. And then they create something magical, which is what I always say. The incredible thing is you take the raw item and turn it into something special and magical. And like tonight, you will see a change, a transformation with tonight's haircut, as you will see the products being used in harmony with that haircut. Big good evening to everybody that's national tonight. If you're national and live around this area, big good evening, and as well as our international people. Also, big mate, Lynn Marie Atkinson, and also Grace, and not forgetting, of course, Cara. Nice to see you tonight. Also, I should say a special good evening to my friend Ben tonight, and Sarah Scott, I'll be with you tomorrow. How? Good to see you. Hopefully you'll all enjoy tonight your roast potato dinners, and also you'll enjoy watching EastEnders will be on your Xboxes or whatever you're doing, but hopefully you'll tune out for a second and tune into what we're doing here tonight. We all are from Scott Valley Hairdressing. Let's just say a big good evening to the little cameraman. There he is, look. Good stuff, good stuff. Natalie Thompson, nice to see you. Good evening. Dan Metcalf, great to see you as well tonight. It's always great to have everybody that comes on. Also, the Saxon family. Big good evening if you're on it also tonight. So, what is it all about? Well, the amazing thing is we're on number 35 tonight. We were going to do 3 haircuts. It started originally, now we're on to 35. I'll take it all the way until it literally runs out. Another 6 people in the pipeline, which is fantastic in itself. And big thank you to all those models. I know they'll be watching later tonight. But again, it is something special. You'll be introduced in a moment to our tonight's special model, someone I've never cut hair before. Some of you will know the person, a legend in their own making, definitely around the area, without a doubt. But as I say, tonight it's special because I'm going to share with you something that I designed specifically as a training tool, because nobody would back me to make a DVD, so I thought let's just take the Facebook Live, and what we'll do is we'll take this as an educational tool. So for you as hairdressers, you're able to watch something and learn it and use it. For the people that are not hairdressers, they're able to watch it and see it and hopefully have a bit of entertainment and learn something as well to take to the hairdressers. Let's meet the model. Come over here, we'll give it up tonight for a nice big welcome, a nice big round of applause and shout out tonight for Shirley Brooks! Woo!
Hello.
I love it. Hello, hello. So, there you go, you see Charlie Brooks tonight in the flesh. We've actually got Charlie Brooks. Charlie Brooks generally comes on Facebook a lot. Like we have Josh Brown, who comes on, Big Mate, we have Dan Metcalf, we have Nick McCaffrey, we have Sean McCaffrey, they all come on and say hello. Charlie Brooks is one of those people I train with at Saxon. Big good evening. Yeah, say hello to everybody at Saxon because they'll be watching.
Hi.
Say hello to your fiance because they'll be watching.
Hello, dear.
Dan, they'll be on there, it's good, it's always nice. And I'm scared, really scared. I'm scared as well. Everybody's scared, but it's really cool, and that's what it's all about. So it's real, it's real life. So tonight what we're gonna do is we're gonna basically just take you through, first of all, the products we'll use on Charlie's hair tonight, and then secondly, how we're gonna cut Charlie's hair. So let's just talk about the products we're gonna use tonight. We're gonna be working with Fat Mutt Blowout Volumizing Mousse, which will be our cutting lotion. We'll also then be going on to using volumizing spray, which is again the Fat Mutt family, which then will thicken the hair up slightly and also make it more durable for me with the blow dry. We'll then be working with the argan oil, which we'll be applying on when it's wet, as with the 20-in-1 miracle lotion, which again we'll be looking for shine, we're looking for lightweight, and we're also looking for something that is going to be very manageable for Charlie when she goes home. We're going to be bringing out tonight of tonight's special wardrobe, we're also going to be using these tonight, the extra wide plate style stick, so that's going to be coming out to play again, which is always great to use a great tool, which again is what it's all about, utilisation of tools and something completely different. So let's talk about Charlie's hair. We've got a lot of hair to play with, so you can see what we're going to do is we're going to take it off to the jawline. No, we're not tonight. We're going to take
We're not.
We're going to take off about 2.5 inches off the back. We're then going to raise the cut onto the front here to put more of a shape and definition onto the front part of the perimeter, and then we'll do a longer layer around the back. Now the idea is it makes it so that Charlie's hair can be flicked out, she can go poker straight, or she can come round onto the face with it, curly, tie back. Basically, five looks into one, which is value for money. If you were a hairdresser, you were looking for three things. Tonight you'll see world-class customer service, number two, value for money, and number three, consistency, which are the most three things that you have to look at as a hairdresser. And that's what we think of as Scarbelli hairdressing. So we're looking for the value part tonight, which is the most important part of how we're going to make this cut work in terms of value. So five different looks. We're not going to do five different looks. We've got another secret project down the line, which will be coming out, which also brings me to say that we will be doing a live show on the 2nd of November with the whole of the salon. So stay tuned. We'll be at the Green Towers. I always get those two confused. But yeah, we'll be down there. More news to follow on that. When I've spoken to the team and got everything finalised. So let's talk about tonight's Highway of the Hair. We'll be working with the recession bone, Ross Cunningham's favourite bone, which is the parietal ridge, which divides the top layer from the side layer, which really is the square layer to the round layer. Apex on the top, which makes you think of roofs and roofers. Upper occipital bone, which is the protruding bone in the back of the head, which of course if you are doing a graduated bob, it would be the shortest point you would cut to, and that would denote where to go to. We're then going to go to the lower occipital bone, which is a starting point of tonight's haircut, friends, and then we'll be working with the mastoid process, which will be to the corner of the chair, which denotes basically where you go to your corner point to cut to, or if you were going to take out weight off the corner. And then we'll be working with the nape. So those are our bones tonight we'll be working with. So the idea is obviously with that, you have to think about some kind of highway, how you're going to work, where you're going to take it, and again it's really, really important. So that's what we'll be using tonight as tonight's highway. Let's do the haircut. So tonight's first product we're going to use this evening is Fat Mutt Blowout Mousse. Again, it's not just a normal mousse, which most people always say that. About a golf ball size. This would be ideal for Nick McCaffrey, who likes to play golf. So you can see the consistency is very foamy. It contains a conditioner. So if you were to put this into a glass, you would find it would basically disperse into a conditioner. So I'm actually starting work on Charlie's hair immediately from the word go. So the idea is it starts to work on the fabric. I look at how it's fabric, canvas, whatever people say. You want to be able to sort of make this work for you. So it will do one of two things for me. Number one, it helps me to comb the hair through, which is what we prepared earlier on. You can see how clean you can get a line in it, because again, cleanliness is really important. And also, it allows me to see the natural movement in the hair, which is very important. Tonight's blow dry, we're going to go for something that's really sleek, shiny, and looking like glass when we finish. So let's just subdivide everything off now. We're going to go from the apex to the mastoid process, which is our first port of call. Got anybody else on? Anybody else joined us tonight? Anybody else joined us? Rob Smith! Hold on a second. Woo! Come on, give him one quick. He loves it, absolutely loves it. Rob said to me the other night when I went out for dinner with him and Christoph, he said, "You didn't give me a woo," so there you go. I'm guessing he put that on as well.
Sarah Baines.
Sarah?
Baines.
Sarah Baines, nice to see you on there tonight. I hope you're okay. Thank you for joining us this evening.
Buster Dalton.
Woo! I hope you're okay, my friend. Looking forward to seeing you soon. I need to organise the Christmas. Grimace Palmer, nice to see you. Woo! How are you doing, beautiful? I'll say hello.
Yeah, woo! Hi.
Should be thinking, no way. There's Charlie Brooks. I'll say Charlie Brooks is here. Charlie Brooks is literally in my hands now as we speak. This is the first time I've ever handled Charlie Brooks' hair in my life. So it's a great honour and a privilege. So starting point tonight, lower occipital bone. Again, you have to think about the sections, how you're gonna make them work, so keep them nice and clean. I tend to use my finger. Is it on? It's still on. Is it gone? Come on. Somebody just tried to ring us, so we just had a bit of a moment there. That's the first time anybody's ever tried to call while we're doing a live feed. Sorry about that. Okay, so nice clean sections. what we're looking for in this is actually is to make sure that everything is in a nice diagonal section, which is what it's all about. And I want to say diagonal. Most people put in really, really sharp angles. So there's nothing wrong with whatever you do, but in terms of what we're doing with it, we're after something that will denote the line that we're going to cut, which I'll explain to you in a second once I've just moved this out of the way. So I like to keep everything nice and clean because I think you're looking at body positioning, looking at angles, it's all going to come into play tonight with this. So you can see how clean everything looks, it's out the way. And again, it is a bit of theatre. So when you're at college, most people cut like this at big angles, which is okay, but it means you've got to comb that section down to cut. What we're doing is slightly opening it out. Now the idea is when I pull that down, it will slightly be at an angle. So for argument's sake, I'm going to cut the haircut like this slightly at an angle, so it's just slightly convexed on each side. The idea is that when I cut the line, it will go straight. Now if I cut it straight, it will dry and lip up at the sides, basically. So the idea is, in order to get a straight line, you've got to curve it off just slightly and subtly, and that's what gives you a perfect straight line. Don't worry, that's somebody who's keen to get hold of us tonight. That's the very first time that's happened. I'm guessing it's Jason Baines, who's just tried to call, but don't worry. The answer machine's on, it will take the call later. So, three sections. We can see now, all you're doing is literally dividing it down. All you do then is literally just pull it down here. Now you're using the tighter part of the comb, so let's just get the length right. We're looking at about 2.5 inches, and that's what we're after there. So there it is, there's a target length, off it comes. And then literally again on this side, now this is what I said earlier on, just to pull it down, so you've just got the angle slightly, and then take it on there.
Nick McCaffrey.
Nick McCaffrey, great to see you, bro. I knew you'd be on. I actually made a reference to golf tonight, so rewind it back at the beginning, you'll see it. I noticed that Dan's on tonight as well. I'm guessing that you'll be doing me a hotel video later on with where you're staying. Probably, I'm guessing that you're staying tonight in Germany. So hopefully if you're with Wolfgang, good evening to Wolfgang. I hope he's well. So again, on this now, we're just going to go up to the occipital bone, or just slightly above to the upper occipital bone. Anywhere in that area is fine. As you can see, Nikki Gower. Nice to see Nikki Gower tonight. Hope you're okay, Nikki. It's one of our models that we had.
Scott Ranson,
my neighbour. How are you doing, Scott? Good to see you. Hope you're okay. Hope Debbie's okay as well. Got some real celebrities on tonight. That's good. We've got a legend sitting here as well. Charlie Brooks. Woo, Charlie Brooks. It's all good. So again, sectioning is really important for those of you that are actually taking up hairdressing or doing hairdressing. Clean sections, clean haircut.
We've got one or two foreign people joining us. Okay. I can't pronounce names.
Good evening to our foreign people tonight. Sorry, international viewers this evening. Great to see you. Daddy's having trouble announcing your names, but thank you so much for joining us. I'll have a look later and I'll say a special good evening to you. So nice to see you joining us tonight. Thank you. There you go. I did tell you international and national is good. Okay, so now with the comb again, keeping it nice and clean on the section. Again, Neil, that's what Neil Jakes, good to see you, Neil. Hope you're okay. Your photograph will be on next week with the vest, because I'm actually just doing the final collection. So that means that over £5,000 has been raised. So thank you to everybody who helped raise that money. That will be going in Friday, and then the pictures will be going out next week. So you'll be seeing your pretty little face on my Facebook page next week. Hope you and your family are well. I'm guessing you're either on holiday or you're working. But anyway, thanks for doing it. Joanne Stewart. Nice to see you with us again, Joanne. I hope you're well. See the sun from a different direction tonight. It's all good. It's all good. Let's just get this in there, mate. So keep the sections clean because I'm very disciplined in what I'm doing. That's it. You never forget a good teacher. Darren Lavender. Daz, great to see you. Ooh, say hello to Daz.
Hi, Darren.
Chris Marlowe,
good to see you tonight. Are you okay, Chris? It's all good, it's all happened tonight. Told you it would start going mad. It's because you're sitting in the chase here, that's what it's all about.
Tracy Barnes.
Woo! If Mark's there as well, good evening to Tracy and Mark.
Hi, Tracy.
Part of the Saxon family, it's all good, it's all good.
Goldie Tour.
How are you, Golda? Nice to see you. And Suki as well. I'm guessing Suki's on there as well. Let me know when you have the baby. It's all good. Do you recognise the way I'm doing this haircut? This is how I cut your hair. It's all good. Just down the road.
you drive past, you'll see Jason Baines has tried to call already tonight. I'm guessing Raj will appear at some point off the A5 at Sweet Treats. Sukalan. He'll be on there. Conduce. Give everybody a wave, Dad, by the way, because you've not waved through the mirror yet. Hit yourself. Dad, give everybody a wave. That's, there you go. So, again, it's really important just to keep all the sections nice and clean and just keep that bend going so then you can really see the shape at the end. Okay, now we're just going to come through to the sides. So at this point now, if you've got a lot of hair, you would subdivide it, which we'll do on the other side, and you'd work from the apex to the recession. In this case, because we've got less this side, we're just going to bring it all round and then literally just bring it all back to retain the length. So just put the comb in the top, always make sure you get all the hair as you do it. Come through, it's Andy Hardy, come on, yeah. I'm guessing he'll appear at some point, big mate. He always does. Oh, big mate's on, good stuff, big mate. Nice to see you tonight, Limerie Atkinson and Gracie, of course, and Cara. I'm guessing you're on there tonight. Listening through, what is it, the Samsung, and watching through the iPhone. Seriously, that is what they do. It's good. Got to get stereo sounds, what's all about. Right, on the top then, so we're going from the apex round to the recession, passing over the parietal ridge, which is your second bone, of course. Sarah Scott will pull me up later about using the second knuckle, which will come on the layers. You'll have to remind me what it is and then tell my dad. The IPT or something. I forget what it is. Oh, somebody's keen tonight. I'm guessing that might be Jason Baines again. He did try to ring earlier. So this is it, you see. This is how keen everybody is. They'll be starting to ring. Then she said, we've never had anybody ring. We're doing a lot of feet. Maybe we should just disconnect the telephone next time. Okay, so just making sure everything's nice and clean again. And just pulling it down again. Maximum tension on the comb. You see I'm not cutting it through the fingers. Most people tend to cut through the fingers, which is fine. But again, the reason I'm using a comb is because it's a solid item and you can use it as a ruler. If you cut through the fingers, you tend to turn your fingers slightly and make the outer part of the length shorter and the inner part longer, which then creates a flick. By using a comb, it keeps everything more solid. And that way you're able to then maintain a nice clean line and alter the shape to wherever. So say if I'm doing a geometrical bob through the back, I can actually alter that angle to wherever I want to go with the comb. And that comb then dictates as I'm cutting it to wherever I want to go to. And that will then tell me the actual degree of angle that I want to go. So if you've never tried it, try it. It's a great technique. Okay, again, combing through with the wider part of the comb. This is the last part now to conclude the back. And then we're going into the side panels with the razor blade. Then we'll move on to the layers, and then we'll move on to the blow dry. Then we'll do the finish off, and then we'll disappear to do Charlie Brooks's photos. In that time, everybody will be able to watch the EastEnders, play on their Xboxes, put the children to bed, whatever they decide to do. Okay, so just take the edges off, just make sure everything's all cleaned up. Again, it's really just a question of just holding the comb on that tighter piece of the comb, which is what it's all about, and it just makes everything a lot more cleaner. So live again Monday night, well, Monday in the daytime at number 5 Wyndham, as I'm going to teach. So we're teaching again on behalf of Muck. So you'll see a live class if you watch that. And then of course, live again next Thursday night with local singer Dean Thomas. Be the model in here, so we've got quite a lot to happen in the next 8 days. But tonight, with the legendary Charlie Brooks, live from the salon. It's all good. Okay, so you can now see we've got everything positioned perfectly on the cut. Okay, so you can see all the ends are taken off. Right, so now we're going to change the sides. So we subdivide again. I'll come on the side for the purpose of the viewers. Subdivide again now from the apex down to the mastoid process. So again, the product, the Fat Muck Blowout Mousse, allows you to get the control of the hair, as you can see. Keep everything nice and clean. So that length are off, we put up. Yep. compliment to ask you. You happy with the length of
your
Sorry? You come around this side? Okay. I'm going to tread on my foot. I've got human
Kesh
rights.
Baines.
Kesh Baines! Woo! How's it going, bro? Nice to see you. Your brother keeps ringing tonight. Tell him to behave himself. Right, the second product tonight. I'm guessing you're with the lovely Monica. Big good evening to lovely Monica. Okay, Fat Muck volumizing spray. You need to make sure that the hair is damped down when you're doing this part because you're using a razor blade. And of course, you can use it on dry hair, but ideally to get the best results, it needs to be on slightly damp hair.
Sucky says you're doing a good job.
Thanks, Sucky. This is what I do to your wife. This is exactly the same haircut. Right, you come around this way. Thanks, bro. Right, so lift your chin up, that's it. Right, so what we're looking for is dividing the hair into two. Now, we're not having elevation on this tonight. That's elevation, zero elevation. We're going zero elevation. Okay, we're using a cutting edge of the blade, and literally it's a question
Sarah
of...
Farmer.
Sarah Farmer. How you doing, Stalker? Nice to see you. Sound like
Hello.
A Stalker. Guessing Lewis is with you tonight. Hope you're okay. Right, so we're okay. We're busy. Pat Booth, nice to see you, Pat. Hope you're okay. Good to see you. Okay, so looking at the length now, just to see where we're going to. How's that length? Perfect. So put the blade in. Okay, Dad. There we go. We're on. So now just using the blade to cut, and we're just really just creating that nice shape. It's creating a C shape as we're doing this. So we're going from short to long. The idea is as you drag the finger, it creates the shape. And also protects the hair because we like to keep the length at the bottom, which you can see now. That just gives it a nice shape. It's just coming around this way. That's Charlie. You see the shape now as it just comes down. It's just to make sure I've not missed anything as we're going through. This is a lot of magic doing this. I learned this in London in 1992. And it's still very popular now, so it's just a great way of cutting. If you've never done it before with a razor blade, try it. But remember, if you go too far back, it starts to go into a V. So we're just going to take a tiny amount here, because we need a clue from the back. Otherwise you get a disconnection between the two lengths. There it is there, just take that out. And there it is, it's just gone.
Dave
Deacon, good to see you. I'm really sorry I missed your birthday. I hope you had a great birthday. I like the pictures at the airfield, it was brilliant. And I'm really pleased to see that you've got a future plane spotter wife. I hope Louise is okay. This is pretty much on. And I ask yourself, how do I remember all these things? I'll pay attention to what's going on. Right, so. Beaming live from London, sorry, from Hinckley there. It's good to see you with, right, with us. So, just looking for a clue now to see where we are. And then literally coming in with a razor at an angle and just cutting, okay? And then you'll see by doing this, all it is, it's zero elevation and just keeping it really, really tight on the fingers. But again, you're coming in and just taking a nice angle to create that C shape. And again, you've really got to be disciplined when you're doing this. You've got to be so disciplined. And that is taking the section small, keeping it so it's nice and long as you cut him. And the result is you get a really nice result. You can actually glide it in as well if you wanted to, which then creates a really nice effect as well. So just looking at what we're doing, seeing that nice little shape just coming in there. Again, the product makes it cut nicely as you're doing this. It just creates that look, and you can then just singly take the tiny piece out. Okay, let's just get this tiny piece now, just from the back. Again, we just want to make sure that we've not missed anything. Just so that's all there.
Jonathan Greenaway.
Jonathan Greenaway, good to see you with us tonight, Jonathan. I hope you're okay. I've seen you for a long time, hope you're keeping well.
Sharon Coleman.
Sharon Coleman. Great to see you there. This one kills you, don't it? I can tell. Okay, so now we've got the length we can see. We're still nice and long, everything's happening. Okay, so let's just have a look at this side. Just make sure this side's level. Okay, so now we're on to the layers. Get a correct choice of scissors, what I really would like to use. Okay, so again. We're now going to go from the apex to the mastoid process. This part's really important now because this is the layers. This is what's going to make all the difference. So, what we're doing now is subdivide again, come through the back, and we're looking to start from the apex. You'll be thinking about all these names tonight when you go to bed, because you'll understand now why it all comes into play. I want to say it's so important. I remember somebody asking me once when I was live on stage. They said, after I've been through all the names of the bones in the skull, and I thought, I've spent 2 weeks learning this, somebody then turned around to me and said, excuse me, can you explain those bones in the skull again? Fortunately, I got it right, which was okay, but I did think, oh no, I've got to go through it all again. But you know what you do is just learn stuff and get it right. So, now going from the apex, which is the protruding bone in the skull. Okay, so now we're gonna take the sections. Everything on this side of the head is denoted with the thumb going that way. Everything on this side, the thumb goes that way. So let's have a look at what we've got. So we are going to pull the hair out, nice and clean. We're not looking for drag. Drag's when it goes like that, so you need to be really disciplined on what you're doing. So pull it out. There's the length just there. So if we go any shorter than that, then it is game over. So we need to just take that out, which is the weight. Second knuckle, or the PIP, or whatever it's called, I'm
PIP.
Sure. Is it? Is it? Come on.
No, but that's what it is, I remember.
Oh, well done, Dad. You were listening. Excellent. I'm sure Sarah Scott will be impressed with that. She's probably watching Love Island if she's not watching now. So you can see now. So is it PIP, is it? That's the technical name for the bone, but for me, it's the second knuckle. The reason being that, obviously, you lose tension past the second knuckle, and you also will cut yourself, so that's why it's really important. Okay, now we're just coming round to the mastoid process, which is the corner of the chair, because we're moving around slightly. Okay, nothing like a big close up there. That's it. Everybody thinks to themselves, don't cut your finger. But the idea is that you just really be disciplined with what you're doing. Okay, we'll go to the other side. That's it. So everything on this side. Here it comes, there up. Let's come around this side now. You come round here, my little friend.
Quite a few international people tonight.
More international. Well done, Charlie. You've done well. This is a break in the international market. Again, this side, you've got, that's the length, and this is what you're taking off, and you're going to the second knuckle only. All right, you can see I'm moving round the head. So I'm going 5, 6, 7 on one side, and I'm going, 6, 7, and 8 on one side, and going 5, 4, 3 on the other. Again, it's all about discipline and just really being disciplined on it. When you get to this side now, it's a question of being to the corner of the chair or the mastoid process, which is really, really important. Again, as hairdressers, we're just doing this automatically every day. Well, we're talking about people's lives, what's going on, and just generally talking with them. Again, that's cross-checking that way. Cross-check this way. I could get a flick off the knee. How about that? I'm not going to have to do that. I'll stop being on the dance floor. So now we've got, in theory, a layer that's starting to bend round. Okay, the next part we're going to go straight into upper occipital bone now, so we're just going to go straight up there to the top, and then once we get past all this, we'll then bring all of it back, then start doing the top layers with a rounded layer on the sides, then we come into the blow dry. If the hair starts to dry, then we just reapply some more muck volumizing spray, which we're going to do now, just to make sure that everything stays nice and damp as we're doing it. So again, we're going to come into now and add some more fat muck volumizing spray. Again, this contains panthenol, which is really important to the hair. Thickens it up and just keeps everything nice and damp while working.
Charlatan
on holiday. Hope you're okay, sweetheart. Hope you're having a great holiday. Hope the family's okay. I've been looking at your photos. I'm sure you're enjoying a break, which is good. My previous model as well. We're all on tonight. Charlie was scared, I don't know if she still is scared, but yeah, it's good. Everybody's been there, don't worry. Okay, so now, again, we've got to be really disciplined. You can see this now, how clean it is. You can see there's absolutely no dragging it whatsoever when you watch this video back. You'll see what I'm on about. So bring it back. Somebody going through it there. Again, just taking some more of the length out, which again creates the layer through the back. You can see, just keep it nice and clean. I'll step round to 7 o'clock, which again is really important just about this. You can see how disciplined you've got to be while you're doing this. So you're using three things. You're using TOE, which is tension, which I'm doing now, pulling the tension, over direction, and elevation. So there's three things there. So you might want to think about that if you're writing notes tonight, everybody. It's called TOE. Tension, over direction, and elevation. ball coming into play. It's a good job I've not got anything called foot or arm, hand. Be interesting, wouldn't it? I don't think I'm allowing you to be so quiet. Just sitting there, just taking it in. Ooh, what's he doing? Ooh. It's good job I know what I'm talking about. Otherwise, it would be a problem. And I'm multitasking for a man, which is quite dangerous. Okay. So now we come round to this side. You'll also notice that your hair colour will change as well on a blow dry tonight. It'll go a bit lighter. So it'll look as if a bit more richer. Okay, so now we go round to this side. Here it comes, it's my little friend. That's it, I think I'm going to tread on my feet for a minute. Okay, looking for the...
I don't know if you're going backlight under this side.
That's okay.
It's not as good.
Well, if you probably go in the corner and then come
over. There
you go, so why don't you just swing it round a bit. I'll swing around this way. How about that? Yeah, is that better? Yeah, there you go.
Coco Chanel!
Woo! Hope you like your brush that I gave you. I'll be down tomorrow to see if I'll come down and get my line cut in for the weekend. Something for the weekend, sir. So I'll have my parting raised it in, so I'll go down there too.
JB.
Well, we know who that is. It's not James Bond. It is Jamie Bray. Woo! So hello to Jamie Bray.
Hello, Jamie.
Hello, Jamie.
Hello.
Oh, Jamie. You say hello to him, Dad, as well. Jamie Bray. Go on, Dad. Say hello to him.
What's up?
Hello, Jamie. Go on, say.
Hello, Jamie. How are you?
You'll get to meet him one day, Dad. In fact, I think you saw him at Glenn's party. They're all there. That's cool. Right, so now as we're building this layer up, it's an invisible layer through the back, which then starts to really curve. But if you were to blow dry, it flicks out and creates like a real casual soft effect. Right, so now we're going to draw the section down from the apex to the mastoid process, which is again a last section before we get to the sides, and then just keeping everything nice
Morgan
and clean.
Morgan Perkins Senior,
always a pleasure. Hope you're really well, hope your wife's really well too. Great to see you with us tonight, a legend, another legend locally. Hope you're well, my friend. I've not seen you pick the horn for a while. So, now we're just going through again. This is where the discipline again comes back in, because it's easy to lose it off. Now, the important part with this is that you are looking at not just elevating to keep the length the same height as the top of the head. It's also in the arm, so you can see how I've got the hair now. Really picking it up on the arm, so all this is really tight, the tension's on. And then it's just a question of coming around. What's coming around the other side? Here he comes, he's coming around there. That's it, you just disrupt
what I'm doing, that's fine. I'm trying to get a better view.
Yeah, I'll just work here, that's fine. Alright.
I'll just work here.
I've got human rights. That's it, I need to swing around that way.
I'll just film it.
That's right. Alright, let me just swing around this way. That's it, I just need to get around a bit, that's it. Good man. You'll be saying in a minute, Charlie. You're domestic. That's it. It's all good fun, a lot of banter. It's good. Okay, so you can see what we're going to now as we're cutting. Adam Reed! Great to see you, Adam. I hope you're well. Thank you very much for joining us this evening. One of the great hairdressers in the United Kingdom. So we're now just going through the opposite way again, just keeping everything really nice and clean as we're doing this. Okay, so now we come back through to the other side. So again, everything on this side of the head is denoted by the hand as it goes round and the thumb leads, which is really important. And again, it's all about tension. So as we're just coming around, literally just to pull this up, it's honest amount. If you come up on the stairs, you might be able to get it better.
I don't think the lights, but to be honest, it's good.
Just go for it, it'll be fine. All right, so I'm just moving around now to 5 o'clock, just to keep everything clean as I'm coming round. Okay, how does that look?
A bit dark,
actually. Is it? Do you want to go back in? Actually, I'll move back around again in a second. Okay. Just go further up the stairs, you might be able to see it then. That's it. How's that?
Yeah.
Is that a bit lighter?
A little better.
There you go. It's that light. That's working. Cool. Okay, so again, coming into the last section now, just making sure I've just got that corner. That's what it's like when you're playing with natural light, because we've still got daylight outside, which is absolutely fantastic. Check that corner off to the mass door process, so the corner of the chair. Again, just check this corner off as well, just to make sure we're okay, that's fine, everything's working nicely now. If I just get some natural movement going in this, you can actually see the layers starting to emerge. So again, it's invisible layers, so when it's dried straight, it just disappears and becomes an invisible layer. When you blow dry it flicked out, you'll really start to see that layer start to appear, okay? Hey Dad, let's come back around to this side now. So I'm gonna come back around here now and do this side. Let's go, that's it. Okay, so now everything on this section, we're just gonna be working forward to run out of hair. Again, keeping the sections nice and clean as it's diagonally going towards the front. Okay, let's just make sure everything's knotting up a bit. That's it, keeping it all nice and clean. You see, tension, it's really important. Second knuckle, and then we'll just come through again to the mastoid process. Is that PRP? The PRP, that's it. The second knuckle, the PRP, thank you, Sarah. The PRP. Nice to see you. Hope you're okay. Hopefully the roast dinner was really nice. Hopefully Ben is not on his Xbox now and he enjoyed his strawberry milkshake, extra large strawberry milkshake. Okay, so now just keeping it up there on the PRP just to make sure everything looks really good. Okay, so there we go, that's that side. Let's just move Charlie round. I might just be able to just swing around this way and just keep the light right. That's it, just work around this side. Okay, let's use some more product. Again, Fat Muck Volumizing Spray. We'll be putting some more of this in there. That's it. Just to keep everything damp now. That's it. Okay, so now we're just gonna keep everything nicely combed through. Okay, so diagonal back sections again. We're just coming through the sides. Pulling it back again into the mastoid process, which is the important part.
Suki Gill.
Suki Gill, nice to see you with us tonight. Hope you're well. Good to see you on there, brother. See, Jason Baines, Conduce, has been trying to ring tonight. Conduce, that's it. He nearly disrupted my filming tonight. There is only one Jason Baines, that's all I can say.
Conduce.
Conduce himself. That's it. Sukalan, that's it.
Ross Cullingham.
Ross, woo! I have a tremendous amount of respect for you, Ross. I have to say, what a amazing, that's all I can say. Oh man, good to see you with us, bro. We are on the second knuckle. We are also on, he's on there, Russ is on. We're also going to be on the parietal ridge very shortly, brother. Nice to see you, my sweet baby. Good to see you on there tonight. Hopefully Hannah's with you as well, and she's okay. She's just done Iron Man, Dad. Ross has. Yeah. Ross goes our captain. It's all good, it's all good. They're all on tonight.
Charles Marshall.
Charles Marshall. Nice to see you, Charles. I hope you're keeping well. Good to see you with us tonight. Thank you for joining us. So again, just keeping the sections clean. And then again, it's just a question of just making sure everything just stays on really, really tidy. Again, we're cutting towards the corner of the chair, which is the mastoid process. Okay, so now we go back into the mirror. Just make sure we damp everything down again. So we just get everything re-damped. Everything tends to dry out fairly quick when you've got a bright light on the hair. So we'll just make sure we damp down with product. And then we're going to be working now into the back section on the top, and then working into the longer layers through the top section using Ross Cunningham's favourite bone, the parietal ridge. So we're going to be working the section in the back first, then working through to the longer layers. But you never thought there was so much involved in hairdressing, did you? Literally, there's a lot involved there. Okay, mastoid process, again, the apex to mastoid process. And now we're going to go into the rounded layer. So this part now is going to be like the sections of a cake or the sections of a orange. Let's just come around this part. So now we're just going to lift everything up nice and clean. Okay, then what we're going to do is let's just move the chair around and we can get the photographer right. That's it. So again, it's really important, friends, on this part to make sure that when you do this, that you keep the tension tight. This will really kill your arm when you're doing it, because you really feel like you're doing a workout with Jeremy Saxon at this point. So you're not aiming to pull it down on any kind of drag. You're aiming to pull it up. So you see where the length is there? That's where we're taking it off to the second knuckle or the PRP. which is just there now. So now moving round slightly, repeating the process until you run out of hair. Again, just pulling it up, again making sure that everything's right. You can see the previous guide, only literally using it on the second knuckle PRP. So now we'll go up here, making sure again the arm is the important part on this. So you have to make sure that you really are pulling it up right when you're doing it, because if you cut hair, I've seen this so many times when people cut like this and do layers and it looks like that. You have to literally, if I teach and I see somebody doing that, I'll stop them, because you need to be disciplined in what you're doing. So that's your hand positioning, body positioning, thinking about your back and thinking about the guest as well. So now we're switching over to the opposite side. It's the way I'm down, it's fine. So now you can see I've just pulled it up. And again, arm is pushing up as you're doing this, because it's really important. Again, to the second knuckle or the PRP. This is the last section now, just coming through on here. So just pushing up. And again, the arm comes up. You can see how clean the section is. And that's that. And to cross check, you literally subdivide in the middle and then literally come through, which is called a quadrant, which is just dividing across. Remember, we pulled this at a rounded angle, so we now check it off at a rounded angle to make sure it's right. There'll just be a bit on the corner, which there is, and then just come into this side. Don't really want it looking like a tachograph, otherwise, you know, there's a bit of a problem. Say tachograph, that's what's recorded on a lorry, which looks like a very jumpy line. Okay, so there we go. So that's all of the back section. Now we're going to move on to the top section. So, now we'll come back around this way, you can see what's going on. Okay, so now we're going to go down this side. The parietal ridge will be the dividing point. So everything this side of the parietal ridge will be a square layer. Everything this side of the parietal ridge will be a rounded layer, which will create that shape, which in turn at the bottom will create that shape, which is a harsh shape, which is nice. Okay, thanks for that, Dad. Could be a prediction. Right, let's just move this way, give him a bit more space, that's it. There you go. Right, so nice clean sections, take a clue from the back. And then again, the discipline is lifting it up in the air, making sure everything's level, and then literally cut. Set. And then again, at the parietal ridge, which is the dividing point, pulling it out. Make sure it's not too knotty. That's it. Try again. Okay, there it is. There's the length. We're not going to go any shorter than that. And there it comes off. The PRP. Sounds like some kind of track by 50 Cent there. The PMRP. It does pimp. Okay, so again, rounded layer on the parietal ridge.
Here you go.
Johnny Keigo, good to see you on there, hope you're well. Good to see you with us tonight, you recognise this, what I'm doing now. Good to see you back again for a second week. Very good. You did say Johnny, didn't you? Yep. Johnny Keigo, that's it. You remember all this, Johnny? Yeah. Keeping all your sections nice and clean. That's it.
Nick Rogers.
Nick Rogers, I've not seen Nick Rogers for a long time. How you doing, Nick? Good to see you, bro. Woo, hope you're okay. Hope you're keeping well. If Mandy's with you tonight, I hope you're all really, really well. No doubt I'll catch up with you at some point in the future. It'll be good to see you. Okay, so we're now going to go around this side. Let's just go around this way and then you'll be able to see everything that's happening on the screen. So, parietal ridge is the dividing point there. Everything the other side of it, above it, is the square layer. Everything below it is the rounded layer. So again, keeping the sections nice and clean. Now we're going to go up in the air. Just keep it nicely combed, nice and tight. We're going up and literally just taking it off. Again, keeping the sections really, really clean and tight. Arm positioning's got to be right as you do this. And then everything on this side now becomes the rounded layer. Let's just bring it around this way, you can see. That's it, which is always better. So now the arm is really coming into action. This, I'm pushing it up as I'm doing it. That's the length, that's the length, that's the weight in between. Let's take that out. So it's almost like a triangle of weight. So again, taking tiny sections as we're working towards the front. Just keeping everything nice and clean and tidy. Because this is great to do this, because I know a lot of students at college have said to me privately on email about layering. So this actually is a really good method for you to be thinking about, even down to the hand and arm positioning of the discipline. Because again, it's really easy to get bad habits, which of course bad habits, bad haircuts. So
Lucy Cole.
Lucy! Great to see you on there tonight, Lucy. Hope you're okay. Woo! Go and say hello to Lucy.
Hi.
To say, Lucy. Lucy. Not Lucy. Okay, so I said Lucy, I said. So now we're coming for the rounded layer. Again, it's the arm that pushes it up to keep it on there and take it off there. So just bring Charlie Brooks around this way. Charlie Brooks. Woo! SJ's not been on yet. I'm waiting for SJ to appear in Kerry Southam. No doubt they'll appear at some point. They've probably been on a lot of looks. So this part now at the front, we'll just take that off on a square layer. Now at the parietal ridge, it becomes a rounded length. You can really see now, so just come through here. Just want to take off. Again, it's all about the discipline. Because it is, you know, it's proper discipline. You have to be disciplined when you do it. And again, now just pulling this front part up. Just making sure everything doesn't get too knotty. This is the last part before we do the blow dry. So then we've just got to cross check it, and then we're on to the blow dry tonight, which will be really cool because of course normally we break and sort of disappear, but tonight we're actually going to stay on with the whole service this evening. So it's going to be one video.
Samantha Louise Thorpe.
Samantha Louise Thorpe. Big good evening. Nice to see you join us tonight.
Jessica Allen.
Jessica Allen. Woo! You know you loved. You know. You loved. It's good to see you. Go and say hello to Jessica Allen.
Hello, Jess.
Charlie Brooks is on tonight. Charlie Brooks. Good to see you, Jess. Hope you're keeping well. So remember, you must let Glenda know about your Sunday dinners, if you're having Sunday dinners or not. Because, you know, she'll cut you a Sunday dinner. Hope you're keeping well, sweetheart. Right, so now we're just going to go through the opposite way just to make sure it's all level. Yeah, we're all on tonight. It's good. A lot of sacks in. It's good. So now, square, layer, making sure it's level. That's that piece done. The very last check off now to make sure that everything's all level is on the other side. Let's just make sure there. Charlie's so quiet. Charlie, you with us, Charlie?
Have we?
That's it, come around this way. That's it. Your face back into the mirror. You still see you've got length. Don't worry, it's still there. All right. I need to pack. The worst bit is over. And then after this piece, that's it. I'll finish cutting. All right, till we check it off at the end. Okay, so now just check that piece off. And there we are, that concludes the cut tonight, apart from when we do the personalisation at the very end. So we've now got a nice square uniform layer, a rounded layer, and also an extended 45 degree rounded layer in the back, which you can see is rounding that out. We're now going to do the blow dry, just to prove Charlie we've still got some length. Here it is, it's still here, it's still here. Okay, so it's still there. That's it. That's it. Right, so now we need to use our choice of products. First of all, we'll go back in and still use a little bit of Fat Muck volumizing spray just to make sure everything's saturated down quite nicely. And then what we'll do then is apply tonight's star product. Well, one or two actually. We've got two products to come out for this part. We've got the first part, which is a Head Muck 21 Miracle Lotion Treatment. We're using that tonight, which basically is basically what it says on the tin. You can use it for 20 different things: volumizing, smoothing, conditioning, run that through the hair. And then what we'll be doing then is putting some argan oil on at the end. We're actually going to blow dry with this, and then for those of you that disappear and come back later, we'll be using argan oil to be doing all of the finishing off tonight from the actual Muck Spa range. So what we'll do now is we'll do a blow dry. I'll take all the moisture out first. We'll use a paddle brush for a slight change this evening. And then what we'll do then, because remember we're going for something that's like glass tonight in terms of the blow dry. So I'm going to get as much moisture out as possible first. But it feels better now I've taken it off. It's feel better, a bit lighter. And then what we'll do then is we'll add the argan oil and then we'll do the straightening. Okay, so first of all, it's going to get quite noisy now. So we'll have to go 1, 2, 1, 2, testing, testing. Okay, here we go. So grab a hairdryer. Keep everything going in a downward motion. The idea is to make all the cuticles are nice and smooth. In fact, let's just talk about this part. Right, here's a strand of hair. All of the cuticles on the hair lift up and go down. Okay? That's it. So go lift up or go down. So when you wash hair with shampoo, it's acid which lifts up the hair, the cuticle, and basically cleanses it, and then the conditioner is alkaline which flattens it, which we all know that. The same with colour, it lifts it up and then the molecules go inside and fatten up and basically lock in there and you put it down. Same thing with a blow dryer. When you blow dry hair the wrong way, everything sticks up and goes very dull and matty. When you blow dry it smooth, it goes real sleek and shiny and reflects the light. Anybody who didn't know that, there you go. And that's what we're doing right now. We're actually using that technique to give us a shine. Because we're after a mirror. Mirror, mirror on the wall. Charlie's the fairest of them all. Charlie Brooks. So that's what we're doing really. That's the technique and the technical part of what we're doing. So it feels quite smooth. You put your hand on there. Use the back of your hand and just have a feel of it. You feel it. Does it feel smooth? There you go. You just got ooh-ya. That's it. So that's what we're after, that sort of smooth effect. So we'll dry it off with a brush. We're using some diagonal sections in here. And then what we'll do then is use the straighteners or the style stick to really do the finish afterwards. So in an ideal world, you want to get as much moisture out of this as possible. A lot of people would say, why are you doing that? Well, first of all, it saves a lot of time when you do it. It doesn't give you as much armour. And also while you're doing this, you're doing a lot of the hard work and the brushes really just to finish it off. The nice thing is now you can actually start to see the colour changing as it's reflecting against the light. Look out here and out. That's it. You can really start to see it. As I'm grabbing the airflow with my hand, I'm actually stroking it onto the hair, which is making it shine. You can probably see it better this side. Just turn Charlie this way that you can really sort of see this part here. As you're really just grabbing it and you can really see the shine on there. Shiny hair! Shiny customer, shiny people. Happy shiny people. That's it. As it goes. Who's that? You can just go on. First one, just come on. That's it. Well, at least you're not going to do it tonight for Charlie Brooks. You know?
Charlie Brooks! Woo!
Amy Lavender, she on there? Amy, nice to see you. Hope you're okay. Great to see you on there. You'll know Charlie Brooks, no doubt. That's it, Amy Lavender. Yeah. Hopefully your dad's there as well. I'll come and see your dad tomorrow about my t-shirt. This is my special new t-shirt. It's Stuart. I call him Lab. You know what his first name was? Waving. Okay, so we can now see get as much moisture out as possible. We can actually start to see the layers, what the layers are doing as well. It sort of gives the game away a bit. So if they were not cut correctly, then you'd sort of see that straight away. So let's just keep moving those around to those layers now. You can really see what they're doing. They just look great. So making sure the moisture's out, as much as you can get out. Now we'll just go with the attention of the nozzle, which of course we need to get as much concentrated heat into one place. That's why we're doing that. Okay, clips, we've got the clips in the right place. Now we're just going to hold the drill out. We're going to full speed. Take the sections. Again, it's quite hard to show this because it's really important for people to really see what goes on. Just take the small section, keep it nice and clean. Just really just drop it on there. All of a sudden it'll start to look like a mirror. See, I'm elevating it as I'm doing it. And again, it's important just to hold it towards the end. Hold it for a second, and then that really just, you can see the difference immediately. If you're using a round brush, you could really see a difference with that as well. The beautiful thing with this brush is it's quite a nice light brush to use. You can grab a lot of hair when you do it. It just keeps it quite easy. Maintain and you just put the dryer on. Just make sure you just pull it through nice and spare. You don't want to be pulling people's hair out. Right. Cool. So you can just see the colour's changing now. It's gone a lot lighter. It's a nice way to hold a dryer as well, this is. A nice bit of control on it if you're holding it like this. Really just sort of see that as it's dropping it, just bring it into the roots, really dry it in there nicely. back in the old days with this, the blow drying technique when I used to work at Remy's in Leicester a long time ago. 30 years ago now, the end of this year. Amazing where time goes. Charlie wasn't even born.
Charlie!
That's it. Just make sure that everything's all nicely segregated. Make sure it's all combed down beautifully and ready to go, because again, it's all about preparation for the blow dry. Just get the roots, all those in there. Just make sure everything sits nice. Got a lot of air to contend with here. And again, then all you do is pick it up. All about the control. Again, just doing that just finishes it out nicely. Again, like I say, we normally break at this point, but we're actually going in for the whole thing. We can actually see all of it. So there's no hiding anything. It's all done properly. You can see now, just use the brush to get the roots. Again, it's the same technique as what we were doing earlier on. All this does is promotes a lot more shine. You just need to be thinking about these things when you do it. Just going to the top. Just using the nozzle. Again, if it's unruly hair, just put the nozzle on there. And literally keep the control nice and tight. Ultra? Blender. Hello, my darling. Hope you're okay. I'm looking forward to my dinner later and seeing you. Here's Charlie.
I don't know. I hope you like PT.
I hope the PT went all right, sweetheart, earlier. Now you can see the shine coming through. If you finish out, it's all good. These people don't have to guess where we are. Paul King. Kingy. In Essex, hope you're really well, Kingy. And the family's really well. Okay, so now we're going to put a diagonal back section in. Just there, so what this will do is give us more body on the sides. Just go in there, draw this round, and then literally set. Come in here, grab all the hair, bring it round. Shows off all the graduation as well. You start to see all of that. It's a great way to do it. Again, we dry as the old one. Billy Oswald. Billy, nice to see you. Hope you're okay. Good to see you on there tonight. It's the window, man. I did your window, yeah?
How are you doing, Bill?
How are you doing, Bill?
Archie Riley, great to see you. Archie Riley, hope you're okay. Great to see you on there. Hope you're doing really well, my friend. I've seen you for a while. Hope Josh as well, too. As well. So now we can see the control. We're just coming through. Again, the blow dry is really important. To see if we can see you, Archie, at some point. I'm sure Glenda would like to catch up with you. Okay, so again, we'll photograph all this later and people can get a chance to see everything that we've done this evening, all on close up. Again, you see the colour starting to really change now. With the look, this is what it's all about. Again, it's a diagonal back section that we're looking at subtly, keeping the section nice and clean. That's it. Just see where we're going with this. You can see the colour changing instantly. We'll start to do this. Great to see some old friends on tonight. Well, less of the old, but just great to see some on there. Thanks for taking the time to come and visit us. It's good. Back in the old days. Start. Just sort of keeping the control on nicely. Get onto the front, hold it for a second while you let it cool, take it off and you start to see the actual shape come through. You start to do it. Okay, now we're going to go through the top. Again, just make sure you get all the moisture out of it. Nice little technique on long hair. Flat wrapping or trucking trailer. Just keeps everything nice and clean. Again, I don't know if you can see this at home, The colour's really so changing, it's going very good.
You've got a blue and white colour roller.
Excellent. That's good, I'm really pleased to see that. Excellent. Again, we can really start to see the change in the colour coming off. This makes a big difference. Charlie Brooks is the best. We're going to sort of see what we're going with it. He's going to try and have a discreet look there. I've got you set up on this light because it's good for the camera. I'll turn your hand and you can see everything on there. Sorry, Anthony Cole. Oh, Anthony Cole. Yeah, Ant. Woo, great AC. I'll say hello to the great AC. Woo, that's it. There we go. What's he say? The quietest is seen who? Charlie.
Charlie Brooks, the quietest.
He's quiet tonight. Taking it all in. Hugo's watching. He's on there. You wait and see. Alright, so we'll just pull this round, keep it nice and clean, one section. Okay, so, we'll be bringing the stole stick in a minute for more. That will then really sort of bring the game a little bit more shinier. Again, just angling the hand round as we do this. The angle's really important. As it cools, as then it just starts to bring that flick round which we've done. Which gives us a magazine look, you can see that razor work earlier. Okay, Dad, let's come back around the side. Just got a bit more out of here. So I can work out the Saxon this is. Possibly is. It's all in the arms, yeah. It is. Right. We'll get you over this side, right. So we can out, so. So again, keeping the Saxon clean. Truck and trailer on this part. Obviously the brush is the truck. Drawer is the trailer. Okay, so now we just bring it round a little bit more. Set. We draw it off. Set. There we go. Just like magic. Okay. There we go. Now look, something's really starting to shine. You can really start to see it. I'm looking forward to when Muck bring out their hairdryer. Should be really, really nice and feel a little bit different. It's quite exciting. We're seeing what they bring out next. They hold that slightly, elevate it, and take it off, and you can really start to see those layers have disappeared, what I put earlier. Okay, so now, just dry a little bit more here. Again, keeping everything in a downward motion. It's really important. You can really start to see just that all comes together. Again, it's all about sectioning, making sure everything sits right. Like I say, we'll be going over this again in a minute with the stall stick. Okay. Now we come on to the sides. Put a slight diagonal back section in. A slightly better example for you. Okay, so just dry it in now nicely just to make sure everything's clean looking. Still got a bit of kink on this side. Again, just bring it round towards the face. Hold it for a few seconds and let it cool down and then turn it. That just gives you that nice little turn. Okay, so let's just go around here. Get a little bit more, take a bit more moisture out of it, and I'll use good hand and get ambidextrous. Okay. Make sure everything's all nice and dried in. So this is how we are, that's fine.
Oh, good.
That's how we are. We're going to come around to the top and we'll switch hands in a minute. We'll switch hands. Mm-hmm. It's like a magic show. What I say to people, hair is like a magic show. Okay, switch over the hands now, use the opposite hand. You have to be ambidextrous as well. You can really start to see, hopefully now with this light on this side, you can really see the change on it. It's coming in. So make sure you can get a shine. That 20-in-1 miracle treatment, you can really start to see how it's changing the hair, the shine, colour, all really starts to come together. Again, it's just creeping things really tight as you do. That's how it's really good. Okay, just come around the side now. Just to make sure everything sits in. Okay. And I'm literally just grabbing on just a tiny bit. Running around with you. Jeff Lowesmith. Excellent. Jeff, nice to see you with us tonight. I'll be okay, bro. All the way from Istanbul. Great to see you with us. I've been on your estate, funny enough, today. I saw your mother and father-in-law. How bizarre is that? I hope you're well and having a good time out in Istanbul. I look forward very much to when you come back tonight. Say hello to Charlie, Jeff. Say hello, Jeff.
Hi, Jeff.
He's big in the fashion world. He's a nice guy. Good friend. Okay, so here we go. So everything's all now smoothed out. I'm now going to go with the style stick by Muck, which is the extra wide plates on Charlie's hair, and that will really make it shine even more, because remember we're after a really nice finish now. So it's quite nice to do just a straight blow dry with just a real casual brush. So while this switch, I'm going to be using this now. This is our next item we'll be using this evening, friends. We're going to be using the Muck style stick extra wide plate. You can see in there how we've got the automatic helps if it's plugged in, isn't it? I wonder why it's not working. It's not even plugged in. It generally helps if it's wired up. That's because it's live tonight. There you go. So let's try again. So as you can see inside there, you've got the red ionic plates in there. So you can see that takes away any negative energy. So positive energy and turns it into negative energy. So any flyaway hair, it just makes it look nice. While they're heating up for a few seconds, I'm just going to have a quick glass of water. Cheers, everybody. Looks like a good workout. Okay, woo, here we go. So, style stick. What we're gonna do now is go into quadrants. So we're gonna be working in four areas. So this is our first area. Don't ask me why, but I always like working in this corner. So what we'll do now is see if we can get down on the stairs and you'll see it better. Remember, I haven't used this yet, so what you're about to see, or literally I'm about to see as well. So here we go. So let's just put the stick on and you'll see literally just how it all comes into play. That's it. Okay, so take the section, here we go. So because of the nice wide plates, you can see what goes on. So there's a bit of smoking because of the product that's on there, but you can see now there's just two strokes on it. Because it's so long, you've got to be able to get all the stroke on it. You can really see immediately how smooth down that looks and really nice. Okay, so let's move into the next part. You'll really start to see it as I come up towards the top part of the hair in a moment. As I get all that again, nice clean sections. The idea is of this that we really do sort of show out, exactly showcase how this works. So you can see nice big plates, you can get right in there, get no marks either, it's all good. Then you can really start to see the shape coming together. Again, like I said, this is a great workout doing this, it's absolutely brilliant. So we'll be finishing off later with argan oil. Again, I wanted to show the reality of all of this. I could prep Charlie's hair and bring her back on again later, but I wanted to really just sort of demonstrate to you live, you know, what you have to work with when you're working with hair. Obviously you've got knots to contend with, little bits to work with, so you just got to sort of just show it for what it is, that this is how the product works and this is how the products work with the hair in harmony together, so you can sort of see how it all comes together and makes Charlie's hair look nice and shiny. So now we're coming through again, keep the sections clean again. It's all about elevation on there. There's a lot of moving, a lot of angles on this as you're doing it. As I said to Charlie earlier on, it's a lot more technical hairdressing than what people think. So people go to a hairdresser and think, oh, well, I'll pay that amount of money, that seems like a lot of money. But when you think about the training that's involved, as with any career, there's a lot of training involved in it to be able to handle the different hair types. Because let's face it, there's a lot of different hair types out there. and you've got to be able to handle different lengths, different curls, different textures, different, you know, everything's different. People's personalities are different, their perceptions are different, you know, to what you may want to do or may you, what you may do. So you've got to make sure everything's right. Good in-depth consultation, you know, being able to learn what you're doing properly to be able to execute your look is, again, very important. Right, here we go then. So on the top now, we should see a nice shine now. This is it. So just put the plate in. There we go. You can really start to see it now. Again, this is probably slightly faster than what I'd normally do it. I'm just speeding it up for the purpose of everybody at home. So there's our first bit we can see. Just to make sure everything sits nice. So there we go. There's your first section, first quadrant. Now we're going to come through to the second quadrant, which is on this side, so we're going to go diagonal back sections. There's diagonal back section one, so we're now just coming to this, so we've got to watch out for the ears on this part. So these are about 230 degrees at the moment, which is what's going through the hair. Some of you may think, why do you use them that hot? Well, why indeed? You can see the smoke that's coming off the hair, that's not the hair burning, it's actually the product.
Good shine.
Look good, we've got a nice little smiling face over here. Good smiling face tonight, so that means it's good. How are we doing, my little friend, all right?
That's good.
How's your arm?
Oh.
Doing well. Doing really well. So, not a great deal more to go at home tonight, friends, with this. If you wanted to watch the end of EastEnders or catch up, we've literally got probably about 10 more minutes to go here before we've actually finished. Then we'll be using argan oil to finish off Charlie's hair with tonight. Then we'll go off and do the photographs and leave you all in peace tonight and be able to enjoy your roast potato dinners or whatever you're having this evening. If you're on Primal, you'll be eating salad or veg and drinking water and being good boys and girls and putting the children to bed. And Gracie will be staying up watching this tonight. Of course, it'll be infringing very close to her bedtime tonight. So it's great for the people that watch tonight, the international people as well. So thank you very much, as well as the national. It's all good. Okay, so we can now see it all just coming around that turn. So it's on there, which is good. Okay, just bring it on this way. That's the chest is over there with red hair. It's like a punk. Across the street. Interesting to see it fits as well. Okay, still looks nice out there tonight. People wearing shorts, it must still be warm. It's not too bad in here, even when I'm wearing a suit. Okay, so you can see we've just got a nice amount of shine in there. Matthew Sidwell on Lad Out coming at some point and comment about the music.
It'll be on later. Not very long.
So I'm just going to turn this slightly now towards the face as we do this. And that just gives us that slight turn. Everybody always wants to know how to get that turn in the magazine. That's how you do it. You just turn the straightness. So if you go straight with them, then that's what you get. But if you go slightly turned, you can then get that nice magazine feel, which just gives it that finish. Charlie's thinking, oh, that's how you do it. There you go, you say. Okay, so here we go. Last piece on here, then we go through to the next. But you can really see how smooth it's looking now, just on the blow dryer. Now we just add the straightness to it, so that you can really see it smooth out. This is a great piece to actually show it, if anything, just how it works the plates. So, and that just comes through nicely, so you can just see how that works. So just make sure it's all nicely combed through on your pretty little head, just so it all looks good. Okay, so there we go. Let's just make sure I've not missed anywhere down here. This could look different. Doesn't it? It looks a bit more richer tonight. It really does. It looks very, very different. That's what I say. The plates on the style stick really changed that. We found when we did the show at the NEC a couple of years ago, it was actually making people's hair that was red. It was making their hair more redder. So it was really cool. It just sort of made a big difference. And that's what it does. Okay, let's go around to the side now. Okay, so. Woo! Here we go. Next piece. Hi. How you doing? Great to have you with us this evening. Yes, it is live, it's not pre-recorded. This is actually, if you come past the window now, you will see us live. No shots, if you come around the side, Dad. Dad. That's it. Thanks, Dad. That's it, my little friend. Very good.
Charlotte Goldsmith.
Charlotte Goldsmith. Nice to see our assistant manageress on there. Hope you're okay. Watching from your new home tonight. Brad's okay as well. Good to see you with us tonight. Again, I'm very blessed to have such a great team at Scott Valley Hairdressing, which is really important because, again, a salon doesn't function without a family. We've got a great family and a great culture, and like I say, Charlotte is a classic example there. Charlotte Goldsmith got outstanding colour knowledge, and Charlie's going to be coming to see you very shortly for a consultation for colour on this tonight. So you're probably watching now thinking, oh yeah, I could do that.
How are you doing, Charlotte? You alright?
Why don't you look through the mirror, Dad, and give her a little wave, because she'll like that.
She'll be going, Ian, Ian.
That's it. It's all good. At least he's seeing on there tonight. It's good. So you can really see the changes now. Again, I always think it's amazing. Before straighteners came out, we used to use two blow-drying brushes together, which was quite entertaining. But of course, when they brought out ceramic straighteners, nano plates and all that sort of thing, it's made a massive difference. And again, this, because it's such a wide item, it's really good. It's almost like a set of crimpers, what they used to be like, massive. Or mahoosive. Have a feel of the weight of that.
It's the hand.
It's quite, isn't it? Not over there, but it's just nice. The balance is good on the weight. I like it. It's really good. But it's what it does, which is the most important thing. So you can really see, get that shine in there, which is what we need. Okay, so let's just take a little bit more of this, then we'll go on to the last piece, then we'll go back into personalisation, and that's the finish at the very end, which everybody will be no doubt very pleased about. Is Sinead still got hair? She's smiling, Dad, she's smiling. That's great. So Charlie Brooks is smiling. Okay, so nice slight down. Keeps it nice and cool. Again, go to scottvalley.com and you can visit all our offers that we've got on here at the business. You can visit the price lists of all the stylists, including Charlotte Goldsmith, our assistant manageress, Georgie, everybody that works here. Again, we'll be doing a live show on the 2nd of November to showcase how good the team is, bring them out live to the Green Towers, so you get a chance to see them performing. There'll be more about that in future broadcasts. We might even broadcast that live as well, a little bit of that, so people can actually see the team working live on stage, which I think will be quite good actually, to put that out. But Charlotte's thinking, no, yes, let's do it, let's be different, that's what it's all about. And while not working, just switched off, let's try again, shall we? Okay, that's it, okay. And we're back on. I just thought, they don't seem to be making it too short. Alright, try again. Ah, that's it, look. See the difference already? It just really smooths it out and looks like silk, which is great. That's the unfortunate thing sometimes, that when you are using a tool, you can actually switch it off accidentally. So, there you go, you can see the steam coming back off again now. Here we go then. So, pulling this round again now, just to make sure everything looks really good. Again, slowing it down, it just keeps everything nice and clean. You see just how light that is. I did say to Charlie earlier, this would feel weightless when the finish was done, so I'm hoping that my words are the truth and it's starting to feel a bit lighter. Well, I've got an answer. Does it feel lighter?
Yes.
Yeah, good. At least it'll last for a couple of days, which is nice as well for you. Okay, so there you go. You can really start to see that shine, it's looking good. Very good. It is quite relaxing actually. It's relaxing for a hairdresser as well. I always say that as a hairdresser. It should be very relaxing when you're cutting hair, even though it is one of the most stressful jobs you can actually do, believe it or not. That's what my doctor told me a long time ago, but you know, we don't sort of think about the stress, think about the enjoyment of it. Okay, so there you go, you can really see the difference now with the shine and the colour as it comes through, which is nice. Okay, last section now, that's it. missed anything in the corner. Now I want to just make sure as I've just got the front coming round enough. Lift you up slightly, just have a look. Just make sure that everything's coming around towards the face. So at this point, just nice and slow, elevated, bringing it round. And then just really bring it off slowly so you can really get that turn. This is the really important part, this is, just to make sure that turn's in there beautifully. And again, the nice thing about these plates is it doesn't snatch at the hair as you do it. So it actually becomes quite, you know, comfortable for the wearer. You know, this way, that's it. You can see the difference now, really bending around. Okay. That's it, beautiful, thank you. Showing up working tonight, Charlie. Look at it on there, look at the new ploughing. You can make sure you get the new bit as you get told off. Get this set and then I can then go through the haircut to make sure that everything looks really, really good. Okay. Okay, last piece. Set. Okay, so. So, thank you very much for staying with us. So now we're going to do the dry relationship of the haircut, which basically is going along the line, making sure everything's nice and soft, the layers all correspond right, and then we'll go into the last product tonight, which is the argan oil, and do a real nice finish for you and just go through everything again. Then you'll be able to go back, have a cup of tea, you'll be able to watch TV, whatever you're doing. Okay, so stay with us, don't go away. Okay, so let's get the correct scissors. What did I do with them? They are here. That's it, they are here. So first of all, first part is to get you just to lean forward if I can ask you. No, no, just that's it. In fact, I want to ask you to stand up because it's so wrong. Alright? This is what they do in Paris when they cut hair. So I just put your hair some next. I just have to make sure that the length is perfect in the back. Okay, so I just make sure everything sits good. That's it. That ripping the gown, that's it. There we go. Okay, so. See the colour, it's really changed. You should be able to see that at home now, quite comfortably. Okay, so put the comb on and just cut everything off that needs to be cut off just to clean it up. Because again, that's just really, really important. Okay, and then just make sure everything looks good. Make sure you're pleased with it. Okay, so that's fine. Just put the chair back. Oh, there we go. Nice, my pleasure. Seriously. Hey, it's live, don't worry, I'll pick it up in a minute. It's live. Products are jumping out everywhere tonight. Okay, so let's just put you around this way just a minute. I just need you to come around this way, sit towards Dad. Okay, so now we're going to go on to the layers onto the face. So I'm just going to make sure that everything sits nice here and corresponds well. So I'm just going to lift it up. Point cut into this now because I can actually see the whole viewing plane of what I've just done. Just go through that with a point cut. Just to make sure everything just sits nice. Again, the more you move the scissors left or right, denotes how much you're taking off. And again, all I want to do really just to finish off is lift it up. Just bring it back. That's thinking to himself, I'm going to put the camera now. Okay, so just lift it up. In fact, I'll tell you what, if I do it this way, it might be easier for you. You stay where you are. Right, turn it over, bring it out. And then literally just bring it off. And then this just adds a little bit more texture. Just while I do this. Okay, this one you gotta watch your fingers if you do it at home. Alright. Just a little bit of overstroke onto the second knuckle or the PIP. Okay, so there's side one. Now I'm gonna come back round to this. Hello. This is it. So now just lift this up. Same again, point in, just to make sure I've not missed anything. Again, this is really important, it's checking off. Checking off is really, really important, and personalisation, because it makes the hair look individual to the individual that's wearing it. I've always said, you imagine it, and I'll create it. which is what a strap line is really for this salon, because that's what it's all about. Okay, so you can now see that's all been nicely pointed out, and again a replication of what you've just seen me do. Lift your chin up slightly. Thank you. I've got to be able to reach you. Okay, so let's just take the hair again. You'll be able to see what I'm doing there. So lift it up. Elevate to the head, so it's just up to the same height as the head. Now I'm just going to go into it and just turn it slightly to the second knuckle. So what I'm doing is just chipping it off very slowly. All right. And if anything, you're not really taking anything off. All you're doing is you're just cleaning up the edge just to make it look a bit more polished, really. But you can only really do it by just lifting it up at this angle. It's just a great way of just finishing out hair. Just to make
Matthew
it
Sidwell.
Matthew Sidwell, I knew he'd come on at some
classic
point.
Tunes, my friend.
Thank you, my friend. Good to see you with us tonight. I hope you're really well. I just said to my dad, literally about 5 minutes ago, I said, is Matthew Sidwell come on yet? I said, he'll be on in a minute. So thank you very much. Hope you and your good lady are well. And you are getting a good balance of work and pleasure. Okay, so you can now see that's that there. Okay, so there we are. Okay, so we're now going to go into the back. That's it. What we need to do now is just really just grab the middle section. Turn it upwards. This is called fanning the hair because it's like a fan. So you can move the fan wherever. Okay, so whilst you've got the hair in your hand, you can control it to wherever you want it to be, which is really important. It's just not being frightened to do that. And all this does is makes it even more invisible. Yeah, it's gone really, really like bright to the bottom. Really has. Wait till you see this bit of video film from here. Proper lighter. That's really good. I'll check the balance in a minute to make sure everything's balanced out all right. Okay, so just through here now. I need to just double check these corners. Just make sure they're all right. Okay, let's go into the other side. Thank you. Hi. Look, you look far too relaxed.
Yeah.
It's great. It's great to see. It really is. Whilst I'm cutting and dancing.
Yeah.
That's it. Okay, so just gonna be forward. Just want to check this off. So thank you, so I just need to just level so I can just check out what I'm doing. That's it. A little bit there. Just to look, really, it's a visual check now, just to make sure you're happy with everything. It's nice and loose with the scissors. Okay. Woo! Charlie Brooks. So we've not disappeared. We've been on the whole time. Maybe you've disappeared. I know Big Mate's not going to be disappeared because he'll stay on there. I'm guessing Sean McCaffrey will be on there, stay on. Dan will be on there definitely, and also Nick McCaffrey. They'll definitely stay on. I know that. Probably Rob Smith might stay on there as well, if he's not busy making something. Surprise, surprise. So let's just make sure everything's all right. We're just going to get the original brush back again now. So I just need everything just to look smart and be into position so I can check it all off. Don't worry, it's fine. It's just a little bit of a magic movement there. So just bring this round again just to make sure everything sits now. Now Charlie can really start to see the finish. How's it feel?
Yeah, good.
That's good. Okay, so our last product tonight, I'm going to use argan oil, which is the last part, which is like Moroccan oil. Somebody did say to me, as a chemist who comes to me, it's got better ingredients in it, which was very interesting. So I just thought, wow, it's amazing what you get to know. Quality of the ingredients is a lot better, so yeah. It's fascinating. Okay, let's just check this piece. You also have to do this as a visual check, and then you can sort of see if there's any little bits you need to just adjust. Just look at the corner. This you can gonna see I've kept it longer for you. At least you want me to walk out of it saying that. Oh no, my hair's gone. What did he do to my hair? The answer to the question is it's still there. Okay, my last product this evening is Mux Bar Argan Oil. Okay, so again, not too much, just enough. Rub it into the hands. What we're aiming to do with this is just really smooth everything down and just make it look extra shiny. The shine's already there, we've already been through all of that and how to produce it, but this really, really just seals everything in now, just making sure all of the ends just sit nice and finish out for what we do. And again, it's nice when you can sort of work on hair that's so long and so beautiful, really, that you're able to sort of put something together and finish it off and make it look natural, which is what it's all about. Okay, let's take this for you. Okay, let's get rid of that. That's it, but it's nice to take that off, isn't it? Is it? Feel like you're burning. Okay, you've got to stand up to the side. Charlie Brooks. Just give us a little twirl. You can really see the shine on there tonight, which is absolutely brilliant. Again, if you just look at the layers at the bottom, if we just shake it off, you can really sort of see the layers all of a sudden start to appear. The more wind you put on there, the more you start to set. We'll do photos of smooth and sleek, and then we'll do all that for you. Okay, give us a little twirl. That's it, just give us a little twirl on there so we can see. That's it, yeah, there she is. Such a natural. Okay, so this is how it started. Right, so this is how it started. Let's go back around to the back. Thank you. So we started with a square line in the back. We then went through to the razor onto the face, which gave us a rounded C-shaped curve. We then came back into the layout, into the back, which was basically the layer which we pulled out at 45 degrees, paying attention to the tension that's through the hair. So I said tension, over direction, elevation. So we're doing all that as we were working our way around to the corner of the chair as we were cutting it, because we were layering the hair, and that was bringing the shape, taking the corners out and keeping the shape quite strong around the bottom, okay, but also layering it. We then went from the apex to the upper occipital bone and created a rounder shape through the top of 45 degrees. We then came round to the front using the parietal ridge as the dividing point to go with the square layer first, then a rounded layer second, which then comes into playing out the rest of the haircut, which you can see works beautifully with the layering that was onto the face. We then did the blow dry. We then came back, went straight into the line again, and then we then came back into the front, which was the key part of the... That's it, hi. We then came into the face part, because you've already got the razor, which we did most of the work, but then we came into it by doing the slicing technique and the chopping technique, which then gave us the striking technique, which then gave us the softer effect. We then came back through the back using the fan technique to then cut into, and also the striking technique to allow us to get definition and movement into the finish. The products we used tonight were... That's it. We used Fat Muck Blowout Mousse to begin with, which was our cutting lotion. We then used volumizing Fat Muck Spray, which was then our next product, blow drying lotion. So you're there, good center. 20-in-1 miracle treatment, which then produced a really nice blow dry. We then used as our last product, which was, here it is in my hand, Spa Argan Oil, which then we used then to finish off with. And then of course we used this. Use the wonderful magical style stick or plate to use. Okay, I'm sure you'll agree. Charlie's hair looks beautiful tonight. Thank you, Charlie.
Okay.
Absolutely brilliant.
Thank you very much.
Staying with me, just here. Don't get scared. All right, come around here a minute. That's it. That's perfect. There you go. Right. So thanks very much to Muck Hair Products again. Without Muck, we wouldn't be able to produce such beautiful hair. So again, thank you to you tonight, the national and international viewers that have been watching, because we've now been international viewers, so thank you to all our friends, everybody that is non-hairdressers, hairdressers, Charlie's friends, Charlie's family, again, especially thanks to Charlie for doing this tonight for us, and also my little friend there, of course, Stuart Pratt, good to see you with us tonight, and my good friend, Richard Lawrence, good to see you, bro, I hope you're keeping well. Dad, say hello to Richard Lawrence quickly, there he is.
Hi, Richard, how are you doing?
So, It's always a pleasure to do these. Again, we're on number 35. Without you as the audience watching, we won't be able to do what we do, produce beautiful looks. In a moment, we're going to go off and do Charlie's photos, which you will then see on Facebook in the next 24 hours. But thank you so much for making it what it is, as always. If you would like your team to come to our salon or for me to visit your salon, go to Scott Bailey Cutting Education on Facebook and I'll be only too pleased to answer your requests. I'm going on Monday to the East Coast, which I'll be then performing out in the salon, so you'll see a live feed also coming through Facebook. And then we've got another cut next week, we'll be coming back to showcase even more tricks and tips and using more products. But in the meantime, wherever you are, whatever you're doing, whoever you're with, have a great evening. On behalf of Charlie and myself and my father, take care, good night, ciao. Woo!